Yes, please.
Sure, Mom.
Please take care of our little darling. Her name is Abby.
She was born on October 28th. We'll be back to get her soon. We have given her half the silver locket and kept the other half. So that when we come back for her, you will know that she's our baby.
They're calling me, calling me, calling me.
elephants I'll never know. It's a hard enough life for us. It's a hard enough life for us.
Yeah. How did it go today, Alice?
7 million people this time.
And in New York City alone, there are more than a dozen movements. Side drives, central park. Hey, here we are. The 9 feet bridge.
Woo!
Thank you. send word to the 17th precinct. We found your runaway. You!
Oh, thank you, officer!
I found her in one of them Hoovervilles over to the river with a bunch of bums.
They weren't bums!
I had to range him up with her too, but he got away.
Poor pumpkin out in the freezing cold with just a thin sweater. I hope you didn't get hurt. Thank you again, officer.
Oh, no, I didn't. And you, don't let me ever hear again that you run away from this nice lady. Good afternoon.
Well, I am glad to be back. Huh? I am glad to be back.
Yes, you can again.
Fire! What's the worst thing I always taught you? Never tell a lie. Well, what's the worst thing I always taught you?
Never tell a lie. This time again.
But you done, I could have gone away.
parents pay for dinner.
Fine. It'll be nice to see Mr. Wilcox again.
Yes, 6 weeks is a long time.
Yes, it is.
Now, would you all come here for a moment, please?
Everyone, quickly, quickly, everyone.
Everyone, this is Abby. She and Aubrey will be with us for the next 2 weeks for Christmas.
Yes.
Abby, this is everyone.
Hi, everyone.
May I take your coat, miss?
Will I get it back?
Of course, dear.
I really like when you coat, Miss Bell.
Oh, I'm glad it's here. Now, Abby, what do you want to do first?
The floor. I'll stuff them. Then I'll get to the window.
Abby, you won't have to do any cleaning while you're here.
I won't?
No, of course not. You're our guest, and for the next 2 weeks, you're going to have a swell time. Now,
since you will take out all your clothes.
Green is your best color. No, what do I care?
Gary?
Grayson, you get your notebook and we'll start with the figures on the iron ore shipments from Toledo 2. What are we supposed to do with this child?
It is her first night here, son.
It is? Well, Annie, your first night here. I guess we have to do something special for you. Why don't you sit down? Would you like to go to a movie?
Well, sure. I mean, I've heard a lot about them. I've never been to one.
Never?
No, sir.
Well, then we've got to do something about that right away. And nothing but the best for you, Annie. You'll go to the Roxy. Then, an ice cream soda rum lime. And a handsome cab ride on Central Park.
Golly!
Grace, forget about the vacation for now. Instead, you take Annie to the movies.
Yes, sir.
Fudgy.
Something's the matter, Annie?
Nothing.
It's just fudgy. No, what is it, child? You don't want to go to the Roxy.
No, I do. It's just, well, I thought you were going to be taking me.
Oh no, I'll be far too busy tonight, too. You see, Annie, I've just been away for 6 weeks, making an inspection tour of my factories. What's left of my factories with this damn depression? And when you're a man running a multi-billion dollar corporation that has...
It's okay, Mr. Warbucks. I understand. Mr. Warbucks' office? Excuse me, sir. Can I have a room call?
Good. Hello, Barney! Yes, I got it an hour ago. No, Detroit, Chicago. Barney, I didn't like what I saw up there. Factory shut down. My factory shut down! You're not a toot when I'm not making money, nobody is. And damn it, Barney, your pal Roosevelt's gotta do something correct. He's gotta come up with a new plan. A new approach. A new something. Yes, I know he's a Democrat, but he's a human being, too. Fine, I'll talk to you about it. Come over here tonight. I can show you the... Barney, make it tomorrow. Tonight I've got a date with an 11-year-old girl. I'll be thinking, she's 12. Barney? Great.
Yes, sir?
Coach.
Yes, sir.
Great, so come to a course?
Will he be wanting the Bentley trial or the Duesenberg?
The Duesenberg. No?
Walk? To the rocks?
Sure, why not? It's only 45 bucks.
Yes, sir.
Ah, smell that. Marvelous. Fifth Avenue bus dealers. There's nowhere like the air of New York. And you don't realize how much you miss the whole damn city until you've been away from it for a while. Like the man says, after New York, every place else is Britain. I see what is it about you? You're big, you're loud, you're tough. And I see I go years without you. Then I can't get enough. In language far from pure. In a drink, murder can be back. Brother, you know you're in NYC. You could be too crazy. Too hot, too cold.
Hey! Because a woman is thirsty for more, romance in life need not be old. That romance can live at 35 and down.
Oh, merciful God, I hope so.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Oh, yeah. Meryl, only 1 week? What's the matter? Warbucks fed up with Annie already?
Oh, no, on the contrary. Mr. Warbucks is delighted with Annie, and Annie's having a time of her life.
How nice.
Why, she and Mr. Warbucks go everywhere together, to the Roxy, to the Stock Exchange. Oh, and guess where they had lunch yesterday?
The Waldo?
The Auto Match.
The Auto Match?
And she just loves her new coat. She never took it off.
Never?
Never. Miss Hannigan, I know you're busy, but this has to be signed and sent back to Mr. Donatelli at the Board of Aldermen by no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow morning.
What for?
Because Mr. Warbucks is so taken with Annie that guess what?
What?
He wants to adopt her.
How nice. How wonderful. Now let me get this wonderful new string. Annie is going to be Warbucks' kid. The daughter of a millionaire?
No. The daughter of a billionaire.
A billionaire?
And Mr. Warbucks got to be struck by a person to tell you that Annie won't come back here. Ever.
Ever? Mama, would you excuse me for a moment, please?
that we scrapped the three or four bucks. While she gets four bucks.
Coming back down again. But lately I've realized something.
No matter how many Rembrandts or Duesenbergs you've got, if you've got no one to share your life with, if you're alone, then you might as well be broken back in Hell's Kitchen. Annie, do you understand what I'm trying to say?
Sure.
Good.
Kind of? I guess not.
I was in Tiffany's the other day and picked this thing up for you. How did it break?
Gee, thanks, Mr. Warbuck. You're so nice to me. Gee.
It's a silver look, Annie. I noticed that old broken one you always wear. And I said to myself, I'm going to get that kid a nice new look.
Gosh, thank you, Mr. Warbuck. Thank you very much.
Here, we'll just take this
away. No, don't make me take off my old bucket. I don't want a new one.
Annie, what is it?
This bucket. My mom and dad must have been with me when they left me at the orphanage. And there's a note, too. They're coming back for me. And oh, I know being here with you for Christmas, I'm real lucky. It's just that, I don't know how to say it. The one thing I want more than anything else in the world is to find my own home and be like other kids.
It'll be all right. I'll find it for you, Annie. I'll find your parents for you. I'll give her brandy.
Annie, tell me all about it.
Miss Annie, you just see. If there's anyone that can find your parents, Mr. Warbucks is the man.
Oh, there's nothing to worry about, dear. Mr. Warbucks will find your mother and father. If he has to put everyone in his organization on the job, if he has to pull every political string there is to pull, up to and including the White House.
The League of Nations!
And Mr. Warbuck said, I may be meeting my mother.
Seth who just walked into our WKAS studios.
Why, some of the wealthy investors and Wall Street tycoon, Oliver Warbucks!
Good evening, Oliver Warbucks. It's nice of you to drop by.
Good evening, Bert Healy. It's nice to be here.
So, Oliver Warbucks, I understand you have something to tell us about wonderful little Annie.
Yes, Annie is a 12-year-old foundling who was left by her parents on the steps of New York's Municipal Orphanage on the night of December 31st, 1922.
And aren't you now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents?
Yes, Bert Healy, I am now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents. Furthermore, I'm offering a search volunteer. Furthermore, I'm offering a certified check for $50,000 to any persons who can prove they are Annie's parents.
Wow!
$50,000? Wow, all the Warbucks.
Oh boy, 50,000 slackers.
But, Parky, this is no joke.
I know, Mr. Parky. Everything you say is no joke. And you lose your lips, too.
So, Annie's parents, if you'll spin, write to all the Warbucks, care of this station, WEF New York, or directly to him
at my home, for Elite 987 Fifth Avenue, New York, New York.
That's 987 Fifth Avenue, New York. New York. Thank you, all the Warbucks.
Thank you for healing. And I would also like to take this opportunity to thank the makers of all new Oxygen toothpaste with Miracle Case 64 to fight bad breath for letting me appear here this evening. Good night, Bert Healy.
Good night, all the Warbucks.
the one in Canada, where they have plenty of chickens and ducks and geese and roosters.
Yes, but according to my list, there's nearly 50 million Americans that work nearly 50 million.
President, if I may say so, unemployment is not a worse problem. The status in Germany are becoming more and more disturbing each day.
It could be a war.
Germany, hell, people are starving in this country.
Harold, I know that, but the Lord
help the people who are starving, there is no long ride.
The trouble is, it's all happening at once. Stop wanting to take another nosedive.
Sit down strikes, riots, floods, dust storms.
And the FBI still hasn't caught Dillinger.
Well, at least we all agree on one thing. The situation is hopeless and it's only getting worse.
The seventh bottle of dominance tomorrow will be done. Let's run up without tomorrow. Let your bottle of dominance tomorrow will be done. Let's stop and come out tomorrow. Set your bottom dollar and tomorrow they'll be done.
Quiet, little girl!
Harold! What did you say, Annie? No, it's all right. Go ahead, my dear. It's still a free country.
Just thinking about tomorrow.
Outlook, vision, a new approach, a new concept, a
new dedication, a new life, a new spirit, a new attitude.
A new deal! Perfect, gentlemen, I was right the first time. The only thing we have to fear is fear itself. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love ya, tomorrow, you're always a day away.
Thank you.
Do you have those legal papers I gave you the other day?
Yes, sir. I'll get them right away.
No, wait. Grace? I want you to stay for a moment. I haven't walked since the inauguration of William Howard Taft. Annie? Sit down. Annie, I want to adopt you.
Adopt me?
Yes or no?
Well, if I can't have my real mother and father, there's no one in the world that'd rather have their father than you, Mr. Warbucks.
Drake! Call Justice Brandon and tell him to come over to sign the adoption papers.
Yes, sir.
Great. Tell Mrs. Hugh there will be a house full of guests. We'll need flowers, caviar, champagne, and...
And cheese.
Oh. Cheese?
Yes, cheese. You know? Cheese. Annie, everything's coming now, Annie.
chilly.
You never knew it, dear, but you're Annie Mudge.
Annie Mudge?
We were sick and broke, honey. I didn't know which way to turn. The man gave us a chance to work on his farm in Canada.
But we couldn't bring along no baby.
We loved you, Annie. But we have to leave you behind.
Mr. Mudge, we've seen a great number of people who...
I expect to be wanting proof of who we are. We have here our driver's licenses and Annie's birth certificates.
Baby girl named Anne Elizabeth Mudge. Born to Ralph and Shirley Mudge, October 28th, 1922. New York.
October 28th. That's my birthday.
It was in her notes, sir.
I know, but I still don't.
Mr. Lee! You've got to believe us. We got here on the Greyhound this afternoon and went straight to the orphanage. Oh, Annie! Oh, and the lady there said our baby was up here.
Oh, Annie. All the years I've dreamed of putting you in my arms again.
Mr. Mudge, on the night that Annie was...
Oh, here's something you wouldn't know. When we left Annie at the orphanage, we left behind half of a silver locket. And get the other half those.
Rob, look. She's wearing it. Oh, and here's the fucking cat.
Oh, it's perfectly.
I don't know how she's all happy.
She seems to be.
She is. Well, if you'll be getting our new things together, we'll be taking her along.
Take her!
No.
Just a moment, Mr. Rush. What about the money?
Well, we ain't got much, but we'd be glad to give you whatever.
You haven't heard that I've offered a certified check for $50,000 to any person who can prove they are any parents?
No, sir. We don't know nothing about no check. Anyway, we don't want no money.
We don't want no money for Annie.
On the other hand, Cheryl, do you remember that pig farm out in New Jersey? With $50,000, we can afford to bring Annie here upright. In the country. With fresh air. Fresh eggs.
Fresh air.
Here until tomorrow morning for Christmas. Then you can come pick up Annie and the chick.
Oh.
Yes. Whatever you prefer, sir. But I think we should be heading back to our hotel now. Bye, Annie.
Bye, Annie. Bye.
Until tomorrow morning. And then you be spending the rest of your life with us. Well, goodbye all. Pardon me, Missy. Merry Christmas!
Well, this is wonderful news.
Yes,
wonderful news. Annie has found her mother and father. And they seem to be a very nice couple.
Very, very nice. You're lucky, Anne.
Yes, lucky. Just think. New Jersey.
Drink.
Yes, sir.
Champagne.
Yes, sir.
We must celebrate. Because it's Christmas Eve. We've just had the most wonderful news. Annie has found her mother and father. Everyone, I propose a toast. To Annie Mudge.
To Annie Mudge.
Annie.
I've lost Annie.
Sir, that Mr. Mudge, I'm certain I've seen him someplace before. I just can't remember when or where. But I swear he's not who he says he is.
Mr. President, Franklin, I need your help.
Of course, Oliver. Whatever I can do to help.
Justice Brandeis.
Thank you.
came from the FBI.
Good. Comes the dawn. Now it all fits together.
Annie, come look at this. Leaping lizards! Who would have guessed?
Sir, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
Show them in. Great.
With pleasure, sir.
Franklin?
What about it?
Won't you please come in, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge?
Good morning! Merry Christmas, one and all!
Merry Christmas.
There's you, our little girl.
You're a little girl.
Well, we don't want to bother you on Christmas now. We just come to get Annie.
The check. Oh, I almost forgot, Mr. Mudge. The check. $50,000?
Certified. Certified? Paid it to the owner of Top Mudge.
Read it again.
Paid to the owner of The Jig Is Up?
That's right, The Jig Is Up, Daniel Francis Hannigan, also known as...
Mr. Hannigan, also known as Ralph Mudge, also known as Denny the Dick.
Franklin! I believe fraud is a federal offense, and your secret servicemen have the power to arrest.
They certainly do. Lewis, turn them over.
Yes, sir.
I believe you find this woman is their accomplice. Arrest her too, please.
Me? I just missed these people till yesterday.
Yes, it's a beautiful, brilliant, you think I'm all saw you.
Mr. Wolf. Oh!
The jig is up.
Tell him how nice I always was here. Gee, I loved you, Miss Hannigan. But remember the one thing you always taught us. Never tell a lie. Crack, I'll let you know a little secret. I never let you, you little gold digger.
This Christmas?